it's like a cost to be satisfactory. And a Planet Crafter, which I've been playing a bit of as well. I'll get some videos out of that as well. I hope that's alright, because it's fucking loud in my headphones. So yeah, it's a bit, it's a strange one. It's early access. I had played about half an hour right before. It's got belts and stuff like in Satisfactory. And some kind of terraforming thing going on. I didn't get really get into that far into it. Now I don't know whether like in Satisfactory you create a factory for each item and then bring the items together and create more complicated items. I don't know if this game has that, because from what I've seen so far there's no kind of splitters or mergers, and from what I've seen with the machines that have belts, it's only one input and one output, so it might just be like machines are there to do it faster than you do by hand, but you select the recipe. I'll show you when we get into it. But it's pretty standard. The keys are a bit, well, the UI interface is a bit strange. It's just stuff like that. Okay. You're in a cruise ship. You're a robot. There's no way we get this back off the ground anytime soon. The cargo container seemed to have deployed before impact. Emergency procedure 82 executed correctly. What about the 80 ones? Okay. See that up there? Number one. That's where our first proper mission is. This is just scrap. Press F. Left mouse button. And you can pee on it. Of course, I can pee on it. And collect the scrap. Different types of scrap. There's, like I said, the top scrap junk that gives you like standard scrap metal, and sometimes open up that. If you see over here, you got some copper gears, buckets, large gears, scrap metal. Different types of scrap will give you different things. There's electrical, there's rubber, there's metals. Don't need that much rubber to start. It's mainly scrap metal board. What's this say? Press E. There's no real way to go for that one. What resources, etc. blah blah blah. That just jumping over. There's a ship there. I thought I saw something jump. No? Obviously not. Okay. The scrap metal in this game is a bit like the iron in Planet Crafter. You look at a lot of it. Got objectives up in the top left. Just bits of the scrap heap falling apart when I was doing that. Okay. I got this right. Up here, it's a bit flatter. A bit easier to make. I suppose I could just elevate it. Build whatever I wanted to, really. drones coming in. But yeah, this is some terraforming to be done in this game. I've not got around to it yet, because the first stage is like just fucking difficult, time consuming. Got the second part of steel scrap. I've got a pipe as well. That's for water. So you do have to grow plants. Tech tree at the bottom. Oh, that's health and energy. You can build a recharge station. Build, yeah, it's just tab, the build menu. Recipes manual, inventory, the laser, repairs, V, port escape. Right, these are the recipes. If I'm pressing K, this is quite a bit of stuff in it. But I've got to create these two keys first of all. But we'll get inside this thing here. I'll tell you all about it. Okay. What I need to do is get a windmill up. Building the floors or whatever. Just to get rid of this bit here. There we are, four foundations. See, I like this flat area here. I do stuff with it. Base foundation. You notice sometimes there's like problems snapping. It's a bit weird. Yeah, this is it. That's not unlocked yet, so there must be something else, some machines that you can. Drone factories, assemblers. I mean, I've not unlocked this, so I've got no idea how to get that up and running. I just laser it to get all your. You don't lose anything, to get it all back again. I'm going to actually build some ladders. Because I've noticed there's problems now and then with the building on the floors. Like sometimes it won't let you put down a foundation, sometimes it will. It seems to be completely random. But most of the time it's alright, and then there'd be like one square where you just can't build on foundations or floors or anything. Build a pillar, build one of them, just delete it again. Okay, have a pillar. Large wall, times 8. Doorway. Yeah. Oh, did two doors. One for good luck. Four roofs. I think this is just to try to get it to open your board menu up and do stuff. And that's very claustrophobic. I don't think many things will fit underneath here either. small container, 20 square, no, I've got 66. Let's get dark. Press T to get your torch on. No, it just doesn't take this away. Because I will be extending the base for more. Sort, unfortunately. Right, now I've got to go in there and get some exposition and some storyline. That's off. So press C. Rotate it around. Oh, that's still off. Okay. Safety first. It's not me, I'll be running full speed. Okay, exposition.
Welcome, LEAF unit.
That's loud.
I have tried to connect with your systems. They appear to have been damaged in the crash. We are far behind schedule. We must recover this lost time as quickly as possible. I am Pal, the sentient AI tasked to restore this planet. Updating data log now. You require two keys. A biological key and a technology key. I must know you are capable of these tasks to justify the odds of mission success. You must enter these keys to activate atmospheric stabilization. After analysing damage from the crash, I have been able to calculate a fix for communication with you throughout this mission. However, I am still unable to take control of your unit. Executing subroutine now. Connection successful. We now have planet-wide communications.
But yeah, that's the basic. This is the bio level. access to the NWR stuff. Atmospheric stabilizers status locked. Okay. Right. So, that's what I was saying about a bit like Planet Crafter, where you have the terraform and stuff. But, right. As you can see, I'm starting to lose a bit of energy. So, I'm going to need to build some power. Well, apparently you used to have to build support poles and stuff like that, otherwise things would collapse in previous versions, but that's been changed, you no longer have to do that. So what does a power? 5 small gears, 2 large gears. Where did I build my craft emergency? Just pick that up. Fine, I've got enough for 2, don't wish copper. We have got 4. Scrap can be made from 5 scrap metal. Steel can be 5 buckets of steel. That's for turning the seeds. We got seeds in the base we've just been in. So maybe when you plant them, turn to plants and get more seeds out of them, and do the cycle again. This is for handcrafted stuff. Small gears is 2 steel, and that's 4 steel. Okay, I don't know if that's the same inside the machines. Only want me to find out. Now we need to recharge and the new power. And it's basic capacitors. What do I have in here? It's not working, it's 2 o'clock in the morning here though. Right, 20 scrap metal, yep. 10 small gears, I need 2 more small gears, and I've got enough. So I need 2 more small gears. Let's create 2. We don't need steel, do we? It's a bit annoying, but what I need is some clean space. I'm just going to put my power units over here. So, first of all, this only has one power node coming out of it. don't need 8 units at the moment, but it's also good to have more than you need. Now, these power poles cost a lot, don't they? Yeah, I need 2 capacitors per power pole. How much does hadronic capacitors? Perhaps just a bit of steps up that side. One to join those two together, and one to put up here to power my recharge unit and have spirit coming out. Right, only 2 of these. Be nice to have if, like in Satisfactory, had a build cube. 20 metal, I've got that. Noisy, it doesn't do that itself. Three steel scrap. I've got 2, so make one more steel scrap. I need 2 of it, so I need another 3. Yeah. 4 basic capacitors. And that creates 4 of them. What am I missing? Copper, I've got 2. Steel, I've got 2. Steel. Where's the rubber? I need some plastic and another small steel. Plastic, plastic, plastic. I haven't found any plastic yet, have I? Is this plastic? Circuit board thing. Steel. And 2 lots of basic. 4 of those. This creates 4. This creates 4 of those. Right. Now. These, oh, I haven't got cables, I always forget the bloody cables. Even though it's got 4 connections on those, if you're going to daisy chain them together, use 1 for it to come in, 1 for it to go out, and you can get a maximum of 2 items connected to one other side of this. I need a recharge station. I need it at the moment. Copper scrap, steel scrap, basic capacitors. What's the power cables like? Copper and rubber. 5 to 1 to make copper. Just need lots and lots and lots and lots of copper. I just don't know how much of this you can automate, whether like say you do like one line for just making steel, one line just for making copper, one line just for making the right faces and see the power is onto the left. God, that's loud. I'm sure I turned down the volume. Alt to rotate. Maybe you can do it with... No, you can, yeah, you just have to... Okay. Grid generation 10, grid usage 0. I thought we'd do it 8 each. Don't use anything. Yeah, there we go. That was a bit. That was a big jump, Jesus. Okay, so now I can recharge. Let's see if there's a slow going on. Why is that glowing? The first 30 minutes. So there's a lot of handcrafting at the moment. But I'll do all to save at the moment. What I'll do is you can see down here as well, wind speed. Maybe that's where the generation changes. Now it's doing 10, that's 5 each. Maybe it's faster, it generates more. Also, the solar panels, obviously, they only work during the day, and that is how effective they are as well. But that kind of batteries as well. I'll go through the solar panels and batteries. It says it stores up to 500, but no, these typical calls 1,000, so I don't know. Again, they've only got. There's no daisy chaining, there's only got one connection on these items. And anyway, that's for hand shredding. This could run a belt to it. This is belt felt shredder. This sounds like it's a splitter, but it's not. What it actually does is will take gray metal scrap and turn it into these. See, one scrap metal, this is two shredded scrap, one rubber is four shredded rubber, one electronics is two, blah blah blah. Turns it into these, separates it out. And that is used in the smelter. Go somewhere so you see the size of them. I mean, that's freaking huge. The hand shredder. See, it's only got one belt input on the right and one belt output. That's the belt valve shredder. The separator then does these, but you're going to set one recipe at a time, so that's got me thinking, do you have to do one line for each of them, and then one of these, then one of these. I think the dark is water area. I am here at the moment. I think that's water there. It looks more like liquid copper or something, but I think it's water. So, if you know about this game, drop a comment and let me know whether it's better to just do like a long line of input, a big container with a belt going to that, because the fabricator ends up making the ingots. Oh, the smelter makes the ingots. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 lines really. Is it really going to be that necessary? Copper, gold, rubber. Why is it duplicated? Oh, this is the foundry. Because it says bottle auto foundry. And that uses scrap metal to the ingots, whereas this. Oh yeah. It's the same. So what the hell is, what's the point of having all this? Because he's needing this as well. Anyway, I'll look into what a smelter actually needs as an input, whether it needs to come from here into there, or do you just put this stuff straight into the smelter and get out and just stick it to the concrete. Anyway, I'll end this episode here, do a bit of base building, do a bit of a clearing up around here, clearing some space, and working stuff out, and I'll see you in the next episode. If you know anything about it, how this all works, drop a comment in. See you next time.